got the whole world. In his head he's got this hole. And in his head he's got this whole world. And in his head he's got the whole wide world in his head. He's got the whole world. And in his head.
Yes, he got the whole world in his hand. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord tonight, this morning, amen, this evening, wherever you're listening. Welcome once again, amen, to REMC Gospel, What a Man Gospel Church, amen. Pastor Warren J. Smith, a.k.a. the Gospel Writer, is now on the air. Call a friend, call a neighbor, call somebody and tell them, amen, that they can just hook up with rmcgospel.com, amen, and you will hear and see Pastor Warren J. Smith, amen. I want to greet you tonight, amen, as always, in the name that is above every name, and that's the name of Jesus, for the Bible tells us that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue, hallelujah, must confess that Jesus is Lord. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Isn't that all right? Hallelujah. Ain't no other name given among men under heaven whereby we must be saved. For it is at the name of Jesus every knee shall bow and tongue must confess. Hallelujah. Now that's all right, amen. You ain't no wishy-washy about it, amen. It's what Jesus say, amen. That's why we ought to tell the people of God the truth, amen. Hallelujah. Oh, yeah. And I remind you over and over and over, amen. You can't go wrong, amen, when you're telling somebody the truth. See, the truth don't never change. You can't twist it. You can't turn it, amen. You can't pump it up, amen. You can't add to it. You can't take away. Because it is what it is. Hallelujah. The truth will make you free. And we are tangled up in the world now. Confusion everywhere. All over the place. Hallelujah. That's why we neglect God. Amen. See, when you neglect God in being in your life, you have problems. Hallelujah. That's why Jesus came. Amen. He came to seek and save all those that are lost, those that are confused, amen, that don't know their way, praise God. There's only one way, amen. And I declare unto you tonight, Jesus declared that he was that way. Hallelujah. In the book of Psalms, amen, 103rd chapter, the word says, bless, hallelujah, the Lord, O my soul and all that is within me. Hallelujah. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits, who forgiveth all thine iniquities, and who what? heal all thine disease. Hallelujah. Isn't God good? Oh, yeah. And he didn't call who or a certain particular group of people. Hallelujah. It just says, bless the Lord, whomever you are at the sound of my voice. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. With all thine heart. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. He said, who redeemed thy life from destruction. See, he brought you out. Amen. He seen you going the wrong way, and he redeemed you. Amen. Your life from destruction. And he crowned thee with loving kindness and tender mercies. Ha. Mercy by itself, you know, is tender, but with his tender mercies. See, God loves you with an everlasting love. Amen. That's why I tell you over and over, forget about what man is telling you. Man can't, they ain't got a heaven or they ain't got a hell to put nobody in. Amen. We all, even us preachers, we need Jesus. Amen. He is the author. He is the finisher of our faith. Amen. Hallelujah. The Bible tells us that. Yes, the Bible, which is the word of God. Amen. Hallelujah. If you got Jesus, you ain't got to worry about nothing, because that's all you need. Amen. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Lean not into thine own understanding. All thy ways acknowledge him, and he will direct your paths. Hallelujah. Yes, you. Hallelujah. Oh, glory. God sees what you're going through, dear hearts. He knows what you're going through. Hallelujah. He is the answer for your problems. Hallelujah. But you got to take all your burdens to the Lord and leave them there. And you don't have to beg him. Just ask, and it shall be given. Seek and you shall find, and knock and the door will be opened unto you. And it goes on, it says, who satisfied thy mouth with good things, so that thy youth is renewed, hallelujah, like the eagle. The Lord exalted righteousness, the judgment for all, amen, that are oppressed. The Lord, amen, he will bring you out, hallelujah, out of your sin, sick, and diseased world, praise God. But you got to trust him. Look what it says. He had made known his ways unto Moses. We know what Moses did. Amen. And the acts unto the children of Israel. We know what happened with the children of Israel. You know how Moses led them across the Red Sea. Amen. Oh, yeah. And then they still had a mind of their own, wanted to do their own thing, praise God. But see, there was a virgin by the name of Mary. Amen. And the Holy Ghost overshadowed her and brought us Jesus Christ, the Lord. Amen. And he is the Savior of the world. For St. John 3:16 lets us know, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but they should have everlasting life. Hallelujah. He made known his ways unto Moses and his acts unto the children of Israel. The Lord is merciful and gracious. Watch this. Slow to anger and plenteous in mercy. So I submit to you tonight, amen. I don't care what you're going through, amen. You may be saying, oh, Lord, oh, God, I'm so tired. Oh, Lord, oh, Lord. Look, wait on the Lord. God will have the last say. Hallelujah. The Bible say, let patience have her perfect work in time, wanting nothing. Amen, amen. Let me enjoy this clip, which I want you to check this out, amen. This is all about what thus said the Lord, amen. Hallelujah. This is God's plan for you tonight. Hallelujah. Check him out.
Ah, thus said the Lord. He's going to break it down to you in a minute. Amen. Hallelujah. So that's why I always tell you, it don't matter what you go through. Satan, he come to kill and steal and destroy. But Jesus came that you might have life. Isn't that right? And have it more abundantly. Hallelujah. Jesus said, I am the door. Glory to God. Didn't he say that?
Yes, he did.
Hallelujah. To him, he said, nah. The door shall be open unto you. Seek and ye shall come. Hallelujah. Ask and it shall be given unto you. Isn't that right? God is sending comfort to the church today. say what I say.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So it's not what I say. It's what God says.
That's it.
Isn't that right? Amen. I am not even in the equation.
Not so.
I can submit to you this. There is a justifiable I with me. And that is, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. Thus saith the Lord. Isn't that right? Hallelujah.
No way.
I can do all things
through Christ.
Through Christ.
Through Christ.
Yes.
And all things are possible.
And all things are possible to him that what?
Believe
it.
All right.
Well, now you mean you got to have faith? Yeah. you can't have this journey. Now go on this journey. You ain't got no faith. No, no, no. Uh-uh. See, God is the only one to know what your tomorrow is going to be.
Yeah.
Huh?
Right.
You got to have faith to know that God is in control of your life. No man is an island. We walk
by faith
and not by sight. Huh?
Got it.
Hallelujah. Faith is believing. And believing is receiving what thus said the Lord.
Amen.
Is true.
Amen.
It was Jesus that said, you should know
the truth.
It's going to make you free.
Amen.
You see what I'm saying? Yeah. Hallelujah. So it ain't about our gospels.
Yeah.
We can forget that. It's about God's word. Get that right.
Come on down.
And the truth will set you free.
And the truth will make you free. And to whom the Son set free,
it's free
to lead. So let's get it right. Not make and set, put it right. To whom the Son set
free.
Time is free indeed. You know, that makes me feel really when I realize. I said realize.
Oh, yes. Hallelujah. That's what we need, the truth. Amen. That's what's going to make us free. Hallelujah. Now, oftentimes I hear people say set free, amen. I done taught you and told you over and over, amen. Set and make are two different things, amen. Hallelujah. You need to learn it for yourself, amen. Hallelujah. So don't just listen and hearken and amen to everything that you hear. You got to try the Spirit by the Spirit and see whether it is of God. The Bible says, beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the Spirit. And see whether it is of God. Why? Because many false prophets are going out into the world and are deceiving many folks with their big category words and all these different things. Amen. It sounds good. Hallelujah. Oh, seem like it might be the right thing. Amen. Everybody doing it. Amen. Well, why not? Amen. Well, I'll tell you, the Bible tells us that is the way that seem right. But the end thereof are the ways of death. The Bible goes on and said, he had not dealt with us after our sins, nor rewarded us according to our iniquities. For as high, whoo, glory, for as the heaven is high above the earth, so great is his mercy toward them that fear him. As far as the east is from the west. Now look at that. You think man could put that together like that? As far as the east is from the west. Hallelujah. So as he removed our transgressions for us, away from us. It goes on and say, like as a father pitied his children, so the Lord pitied them that fear him. For he knoweth our frame. He remembered that we are dust. As for man, his days are as grass, as a flower of the field, so he flourish. And the wind passeth over it, and it is gone. And the place thereof shall know it no more. But the mercy, hear me, the mercy of the Lord, hallelujah, is from everlasting to everlasting upon them that fear him. And his righteousness until the children's children. So it's important and effective that you pray, amen, for your children, amen, and give them to the Lord. train them up the way that they should go. We know they got all kind of stuff going on, amen. But see, the age of accountability and knowing when to come back to God is when God convicts you in your heart. Sometimes he allow you to go out there and you doing this and you doing that and everybody else is doing it and you think it's all cool and all that kind of stuff. Amen. One day, hallelujah, he going to shake you and say, now, wait a minute. Do that really make sense to you? And you begin to question yourself. I know everybody's liking this. Amen. But is this pleasing to God? There's only one way. And that way is God's way. Hallelujah. And it goes on and says, but the mercy of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting upon them that fear him and his righteousness unto his children's children, to such as keep his covenant and to those that remember the commandments to do them. Hallelujah. The Lord had appeared, prepared his throne in the heavens and his king rule over all. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless the Lord, ye his angels, and excel his strength, and do his commandments, hearken unto the voice of his word. Hearken, listen to the voice of his word. Bless the Lord, all ye hosts. Bless the Lord, ye ministers, amen, of his that do his pleasure. Bless the Lord, all his works and all the places of his domain. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. You see, with God, there is no respect to person. Hallelujah. He don't choose this way for this person because of what this person does, or this way for this person because of what this person does. No, we're all one in Christ Jesus. Amen. Accepting and believing the fact that there's one Lord, one God, one faith, one baptism. Hallelujah. God is the Father of us all. Hallelujah. Some folk call him whatever they want to call him, amen. But, you know, that's the part I'm not at the level to understand or explain, amen, all these different what they call denominations, amen. But we need to be holy. That's according to the word of God. God said, be ye holy, for I am holy, for holiness which without no man shall see the Lord. So I want to be like God. Now, holy, that means being set apart. It means like you're in the world, but you're not of the world. What am I saying? I'm saying that everybody's doing their thing. Oh, they jumping and shouting. They got all these holidays, Valentine's and all this stuff. Oh, my God. And they're celebrating the Christmas and the Easters and all. Man, look, you better get caught up, amen, with the Lord, amen. You better know God for who God is. Hallelujah. Fret not thyself because of evildoers, neither be thy envious against the workers of iniquity. In other words, don't worry about what other folks are doing. Hallelujah. You do you, amen. Hallelujah. Let them do them and you do him. But see, you doing you can be effective enough that they can see Christ in you, amen, and your light shine effective, and it'll bring them out of darkness because curiosity will kick in. Huh? Oh, yeah. You know what they'll say? Why are you always happy? Don't you see the world is on fire? Why are you not worried? Why are you not worried about nothing? Because you're trusting God. Then there are examples, you know. Don't forget Daniel in the lion's den. Everybody worried but Daniel. He was the one in the lion's den. But God, what? Shut the mouth of the lions. Or Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in the fiery furnace. They wasn't going to eat. They wasn't going to entertain the king's food and all what the king had. Throw them in the fire. Burn them on up. Fire so hot. The men that threw them in there got burned. And lo and behold, when they realized and try to find out how burnt or how dead or what they looked like dead was, they was in there not even touched by the flame. Huh? No respect to person. God did all that for them to let you know that he can do all things. That's nothing too hard for God to do. Hallelujah. And we have to work where we have our faith become active in our life. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Faith is an important element to have in your life. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. I'm not just telling, this is the word of God. That's why it's important to not leave the word. You got to get this down in here. Amen. Ha, glory to God. Yeah. You can't prepare nothing, amen, to stand before the people of God that's hurting, amen, and give them some kind of prescription, amen, from your mental capacity, amen. No. You just tell them, take it to Jesus. And they got to have faith enough to believe that if they take it to Jesus, Jesus is going to make it all right. Hallelujah. Oh, yes. The Bible says they present your body a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto the Lord, which is your reasonable service. It ain't but one way. I don't care how you look at it or who going all these other different thousand ways. It ain't but one way. Jesus is the way. He's the beginning. He's the end. He's the first. He's the last. He's the Alpha and the Omega, the same yesterday, today, and forever. And he even tells us, let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. Then he said, in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. He says, I go to prepare. Think about that. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I'll come again and receive you unto myself. That where I am, there ye may be also. That's love. That's love. Look, let not your heart be troubled. Don't worry about nothing. Hallelujah. These folks, amen, they got their own guideline and their own avenue, their own ways, and how they feel like what it is. See, a lot of them got so caught up into the world till they satisfied and pleasing the flesh, amen. That flesh feels good. Oh, yeah. Why you want to give this up? Listen, it ain't about the flesh. God is spirit. And they that worship God must worship him in spirit and in truth. Nothing complicated about it at all. Spirit and in truth. Hallelujah. So, what are you waiting for? Why aren't you saved? Why aren't you walking with the Lord like your grandma taught you? What done happened? You know better. Why you doing what you doing now? You ain't been doing all that. Oh, you done got caught up with a whole group of folk and look like they're having a good time, so you going to jump on that bandwagon. Oh, yeah, huh? Yeah, keep on going. Keep on going. The Bible says, delight yourself also in the Lord, and the Lord will give you the desires of your heart. But you got to dwell in that secret place of the Most High. You got to abide under the shadow of the Almighty. The word God said, I'll never leave you. I'll never forsake you. I'll be with you even to the end of the world. But you got to trust in the Lord wholeheartedly. Hallelujah. Oh, yes. There are no impossibilities in God. See, all that's possible to man or impossible to man is possible to God. But there are no impossibilities in God. See, God can fix it. You're going through this, well, I mean, just talk to the Lord. And just have a talk with him. I mean, talk like I'm talking to you. Talk to the Lord. He has an all here and there. He hears what you're saying. He knows where you're going. He knows your heart. He knows your mind. Huh? The Bible says, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. The Bible says, set your affections on things above, not on things on this earth. Look around this earth and see what's going on. All this trouble and turmoil going on, confusion. This is a mess. Hallelujah. But God loves each and every one of us in spite of the mess that we in. Now look at that kind of love. Hallelujah. And while we are in our mess, doing our worst, he died for us. Christ hanging on the cross. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. So if ever was a time for us to know the Lord, now is that time. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Hallelujah. Now I see why David could say, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. I can see why he said that. Now, David wasn't no Holy Ghost two-shoot. David was something else. Oh, yeah. But look what he prayed. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He making me to lie down in green pastures, leading me beside the still waters, restoring my soul, leading me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Look at what David, listen at this guy. Hallelujah. Look at his communication with God. God gave him favor. Hallelujah. Oh, yeah. And there's no respect to person. What he did for him, he'll do it for you. Oh, yeah. We are still yet walking in the battlefield of the Lord. Hallelujah. So it ain't what I say. It ain't what your bishop say or your preachers say, or your mission, whatever you are, however high you climb, it ain't got nothing to do with it. It's what God say that counts. Listen, if it had not been for the Lord on your side, where would you be? Huh? Say that to yourself. If it had not been for the Lord, where would you be? Huh? Yeah. Now, you're not going to live forever. The Bible says it is appointed unto man once to die, after that, the judgment. So I submit to you to seek the Lord now while he may be found, and call upon him while he is near. And he's more near now than he ever been, amen, because this world is on fire. Hallelujah. Oh, yeah. And it ain't going to get no better. It ain't going to get no better. You hear me? Hallelujah. I'm just giving you the word. That's what the word say. Nations rising up against nations. Earthquakes in divers places. Famine in the land. Walls and rumor of walls. Kingdom against kingdom. All this mess is going on. But we were forewarned about that, wasn't we? Hallelujah. So I, as a minister of the gospel, submit to you to seek the Lord now while he may be found. Call upon him while he is yet near. Because it ain't nothing you go through that God can't handle. He's awesome. He's omnipotent. He's all-powerful, all-loving, all-knowing, all-caring, rich in mercy. Hallelujah. Angels bow down before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. Love us, not in spite of what we do. Oh, because of what we do. He loves us in spite of what we do. Hallelujah. Satan and the lion, one he come to kill, steal, and destroy. Jesus came that you might have life and that you might have it more abundantly. Hallelujah. So no matter how you put it, twist it, turn it, the wages of sin is still debt, just like it always have been. Hallelujah. Yes. But you're saved by the grace of God. For by grace are we saved through faith. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. That not of ourselves. It ain't about us. It ain't what I say. It's what God say. So I submit to you tonight, as my sister Mahalia began to come. Amen. As always, this is Pastor Warren J. Smith of the Main Gospel Church. I'm also known as the Gospel Writer. You can write me, Post Office Box 470070, Los Angeles, California, 90047. That's Pastor Warren J. Smith, Post Office Box 470070, Los Angeles, California, 90047. If you write me, I'll write you back. Huh? Amen. Put me to the test. Amen. Hallelujah. God loves you, and God cares, and God is concerned. God bless you, and I'll talk to you next time.
Go tell it on the mountain.
watching over their wandering flock. By night, behold, out of heaven everybody.